Happy Friday. On today's show, we have announcements about the upcoming high school musical and an interview about College Month.
We also have some athletes sharing about their fall sports and some highlights from their games, this and more, so stay tuned.
To start our show today, please stand and join us in singing the Pledge of Allegiance. Thank you.
Just a reminder, we have one more day of conferences this Tuesday from 5 to 8 p.m.
Next week is the end of the first marking period, and next Friday will be a half day.
In Academy, you are doing a bingo game to ask teachers some college questions.
Here is an interview with Ms. Kong sharing about why middle school is a great time to start setting goals for what to do after high school.
Hi, I'm Noah, and I'm here with Ms. Kong to learn more about College Month. What is College Month, and why do we celebrate it?
So College Month in Michigan is celebrated in October. It's really focused on a lot of times in high school where seniors are applying for colleges, kind of finalizing their selections of where they want to apply and go to applying for financial aid. But here at the middle school, I think it's also really important for us to start talking about post-secondary options and what you want to do one day when you are out of high school and beyond.
What do you mean by when you say college?
So I really prefer to use the term post-secondary options instead of college, just because it's like things that we're thinking of beyond high school, right? It could be whether you're going to go to a four-year college, whether you're going to do two-year college. It could be like an internship that you're going to do after high school or a trade school, or maybe you're entering the job force because you already have an employer waiting for you and they're going to do on-the-job training for you. So I like to say post-secondary options, what students start to plan and think of that connects with careers that they're interested in the future.
Why are we already talking about college and middle school?
I think it's never too early to start having conversations and exploring about colleges and your future and post-secondary plans. The more you discover who you are, things you're interested in middle school, the more that shapes what you want to do in the future. So just exploring and connecting, like, why is our learning important? How does this help me in the future to things that I want to do? So I think it's so important that we start conversations early, you know, even as early as elementary school and in middle school, so you have more opportunities to explore what is available to help you get to your goals.
What are some activities students can do in Academy to participate in College Month?
So we're going to push out different activities each week in October, focused on career exploration and post-secondary explorations and stuff like that. The best thing that students can do is just be open to it. Teachers will share information with you. Be willing to ask questions, you know, ask your teachers. They all have education and they have a lot of background knowledge as well that you can start to just discuss with them and see, like, what does it look like? What does that feel like, you know, when I go to college or when I go to school or when I start thinking about my careers? So I think those are lots of different ways, having appropriate discussions, looking at the activities we have that we will push out that you guys can just, like, use it for your benefit.
Thank you for Mrs. Kong for letting us interview her, and thank you for Lincoln for recording.
A great quote from one of our previous high school graduates is, "You can't want what you don't know."
We want you all to know that there are many opportunities after high school that will help you in your future.
Now this is a time to start learning about these opportunities and setting goals for what to achieve in your next steps after high school.
Don't forget to complete a bingo game and earn a Pride book. The Pride store will be open today at lunch, so be ready to spend those dollars for some great prizes.
Now over to this week's general announcement.
Thanks, I'm Donovan.
And I'm Yosmer.
The Bacon Club has its first meeting on October 27th in Mrs. Joe's room.
After school tutoring meets every Tuesday and Thursday after school. You can work in the library and get help from the teachers and other volunteers. A late bus is provided for students who participate in tutoring.
The high school will be performing the musical Elf. This show is November 4th throughout 5, 11th and 12th, and you can see the show times on the screen.
Here's an interview with Mr. Huber to tell you a little bit about the show and why you might want to go.
Hi, I'm Lizzie, and I'm here with Mr. Huber to interview him about the high school musical. What show are you doing for the high school this year?
This year, we're doing something a little bit different than we normally do. We decided we wanted to do a holiday show. And so we looked at all kinds of different holiday shows, and we settled on a really popular show, and that's Elf. We're doing Elf the Musical. If you've seen the movie and you like the movie, then I think people are really going to enjoy the show. It's very much, it's a lot the same, but it's got lots of songs and dances and everything else in it. It's going to be a whole lot of fun, I think.
When is the high school show?
So our shows are the first and second weekend in November. We do evening shows, and we do an afternoon show on that first Sunday. So it's coming up in November, the first and second week in November.
How long do you guys rehearse?
Well, we have auditions, and that takes about a week, and then all of a sudden we go into rehearsals, and that takes 8 weeks. So for 2 months, we rehearse just to be able to get all the songs and dances down. You have to remember, we start with just words on a page, and then we turn it into this full thing. So we have kids coming every night and on Saturdays to rehearse for the show.
When is the middle school play this year?
So the middle school show happens in the spring. What we do is we normally have auditions in February. There'll be posters all over the place. It'll be in the daily announcements. We have those auditions, and then we rehearse for March and April. And then the middle school show is actually the first week in May. And we haven't quite decided on it, but we're really close, and I think it's going to be a really, really fun show this year, and everybody's going to want to try out for that. If you like to sing, dance, act, come out and try out for that, and that's going to be in February is when the auditions will be.
Thank you, Mr. Huber, for letting us interview him, and thank you, Sydney, for filming.
Buy your tickets now to get the best shows for this amazing show.
Now over to sports.
Thanks. I'm Santi, gotta go.
And I'm Mason. Thanks to all to try it out. The basketball games will be starting the first week in November.
Girls Swim and Dive also have their first meet November 3rd.
Just another reminder to pick up forms in the Ski and Snowboard Club. This is experienced skiers who are interested in learning.
We take weekly trips on Friday to Bittersweet in January and February by joining the club to get a discount card to get half of the rental and lift ticket prices.
There are packets available outside Mrs. Postman's room.
Please return forms with the money for the card to Ms. Postma or to the front office. If you have questions, talk to Ms. Postma.
Congratulations to all the fall athletes. Here are some of them sharing about the season.
What fall sports do you play and why do you play it?
I play soccer and because I like hanging out with my friends and running.
What benefits are there to playing soccer?
Get to hang out with your friends and just generally have fun with coaches and everybody else. I like playing midfield, just running a lot, really.
What fall sport do you play and why do you play it?
I play football, and it's a fun sport because it's just a good way to make new friends and have fun.
What benefits are there to playing football?
You can build team skills and like you just make more friends, and then you get to lift after a game on every Wednesday, and you get to watch film also. You get to, like, if you make a play and you get a touchdown or a sack, team, like, have fun.
What fall sports do you play and why do you play it?
I play cross country because I like to run and it's fun to make new friends.
What benefits are there to playing cross country?
It helps you to get active and interact with new people.
Way to go, Panthers. Join us in the new stadium tonight for the last home varsity football game against Jenison.
Since it's the end of a marking period, this is our hour's last show.
Have a great Friday, and keep showing that Panther pride. And as always, go Wolves!